हेलो बीएससी सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर ए गैप नाउ टुडेस आवर लेक्चर इज ऑन टाइप्स ऑफ हर्ट इज ए बिट फ्रॉम द चैप्टर दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द कार्डियोवैस्कुलर सिस्टम. Now this is the syllabus. This is the our new syllabus. So dear students, unit first, there is a three chapters. First chapter is the digestion. Second chapter is vitamin. Third chapter is respiration. So these three chapters we have already completed. Means unit first is completed. Then unit second is started, and in the second unit, the first chapter, that is excretion, is also completed, and second chapter, cardiovascular system, we are studying here. So one period from the cardiovascular system you have already done. So in that period we have studied the composition and function of blood. So friend, I am just summarizing here what we have completed from the syllabus. Now, as per your syllabus, today's period is on cardiovascular system, and in the cardiovascular system, next bit after the composition of blood and functions of blood, next bit is the types of heart. So, in your syllabus, about the types of heart, two types of heart is given in your syllabus. So here the two types of the heart. One type of heart as per syllabus is the neurogenic heart, and second type of the heart is the myogenic heart. So these two types of heart is given in your syllabus, and we have to study these two types of the heart. And we have differentiate, what is the difference between these two types of the heart. First we will see the heart. What is the heart? So you remember, heart is a muscular conical pumping organ, contraction and relaxation. So about the human heart, it is located in just left side of the chest, very near or in between the lungs. So heart is there here, and we can feel the contraction and relaxation movement of the heart. So heart is a conical muscular pumping organ of the man. It is very important organ of the circulatory system. Circulatory system is functions under the control of the heart. Heart gives pressure to the blood to circulate in the different parts of the body and collect that blood from different organs to the lungs, then to the heart. So here two types of the heart we will study. So first is the neurogenic heart, neurogenic type of heart. So here in this type of the heart, heartbeat is controlled by the nerve ganglion. Heartbeat is controlled by the nerve ganglion. Such type of heart is called as the neurogenic heart. So simple, the heart in which the heartbeat is controlled by the nerve ganglion, such type of heart is called as the neurogenic heart. In this type of heart, pacemaker is made up of the nerve ganglion cells. Pacemaker is an important organ or important part of the heart. From here the heartbeat starts. The functions of contraction and relaxation, that is called as the heartbeat, is start. So pacemaker, here this pacemaker is made up by the nerve ganglionic cells. And in the heart, acetylcholine increases the heartbeat. So neurogenic heart, acetyl coli increases the heartbeat in the neurogenic heart. Pacemaker is there. That pacemaker is made up by the nerve ganglionic cells. Neurogenic heart, heartbeat is controlled by the nerve ganglia. So this is about the neurogenic heart in your syllabus. One type of the heart is given, that is the neurogenic heart. Another type of the heart is given in your syllabus, that is the myogenic heart. This myogenic heart means the heart in which the heartbeat is controlled by the nervous system or nerve system. Heartbeat is controlled by the nerve system. Means contraction and relaxation, which is called as the heartbeat. The sound of the heartbeat is lub-dub. So that is the sound of the heart. You can listen that sound by the stethoscope. So here, the myogenic heart is a type of heart in which the heartbeat is controlled by the nerve system. The pacemaker in this type of heart is made up by the heart muscles. And heart muscles is also called as the cardiac muscles. Here we are studying about the human physiology. So here heart is consulting about the human. So in the human heart, the myogenic type of the heart is present. And the heart is made up by the heart muscles. And that muscles is also called as the cardiac muscles. The heart specialist, they are also called as the cardiologist. They are called cardiologist because cardiac, this word is related to the heart. So the muscles of the heart is called as the cardiac muscles. So dear students, these two types of the heart we have studied under the heading of the types of heart. So I will just here conclude what we have studied. So we have studied in today's lecture, in today's period, types of the heart, this beat. So there are two types of the heart. One type of heart is called as the neurogenic heart. Second is called as the myogenic heart. Neurogenic heart is a type of heart where heartbeat is controlled by the nerve ganglia. Pacemaker is made up by the nerve ganglionic cells. Acetylcholine increases the heartbeat. Now another type of the heart is called as the myogenic heart. Heartbeat is controlled by the nerve system. Pacemaker is made up by the heart muscles. Now the another point from our syllabus, that is the structure of human heart. Structure of our heart. Human heart means our heart. So already you know that heart is a conical pumping organ, muscular organ, which is situated in the left chest, protected by the cage, ribs. Now, this structure of heart, we can study it by two ways. One is the external heart, the external structure of the heart, the external structure, another one is the internal structure. Externally, heart is covered by a double membrane. That double membrane is called as the pericardium. So, these two membranes, having the space in between the two membranes, that space is called as the pericardial space. That space is not empty, it is filled by the fluid. That fluid is called as the pericardial fluid. And the function of this pericardium is to protect the heart by any way. When there is a bombardment of the heart, so it is just like the balloon, it prevent that bombardment to the internal structure of the heart. So external structure of the heart, externally heart is protected by the membrane, double membrane. That membrane is called as the pericardium. That membrane is having the space. That space is called as the pericardial space. That space is not empty, it is filled by the fluid. That fluid is called as the pericardial fluid. This is sufficient about the external structure of the heart. Now another, that is the internal structure of the heart. So dear students, remember, internally the human heart having the four chambers. So upper half of the portion of the heart is made up by the auricles. That auricles is also called as the atrium. So there are two atrium, right and left atrium. Now, similarly, the lower half is called as the ventricles, left and right ventricles. So, our left auricle receiving the blood from the lungs, oxygen mixed blood from the lungs, oxygenated blood from the lungs comes into the left auricle. From the left auricle, it goes to the left ventricle. So, in between the left auricle and left ventricle, there is an aperture. There is an aperture, just like you see, this is the aperture or openings between the auricle and ventricle. Left auricle opens to the left ventricle. That aperture is called as the auriculoventricular aperture. And there is a wall on that aperture to prevent the backflow of the blood. Once the blood from auricle, left auricle goes into the left ventricle, that never comes to the return. There is a wall. And that wall is having the two flaps, like these two flaps. So that is called as a bicuspid wall. So blood from the lungs, pure blood, comes into the left auricle. From left auricle, it goes to the left ventricle by auriculoventricular aperture, which is guarded by the bicuspid wall, which wall is prevented the backflow. From the left ventricle, blood flows to the different parts of the body, different organs of the body, up to the cell. Then in the cell, blood is in the cell. There is a deoxygenation of the blood. The oxygen is utilized by the cells and it converts into the carbon dioxide. Now that carbon dioxide, which is toxic to the cell, returns, collected back to the heart. From the heart, it goes to the lungs for purification. The carbon dioxide is expelled outside and the fresh air, oxygen, is taken inside the body. In this way, contraction and relaxation movement in the internal structure, auricle to ventricle, from left auricle to left ventricle, from right auricle to the right ventricle. So, internally there is the four chambers and rough structure of the heart. Here I can show you, this is just like the, this is the rough structure. So, this is the left auricle, this is the left ventricle, this is the right auricle, this is the right ventricle. Here is the openings. That openings is called as the auriculoventricular aperture. In the left side, the wall is present, which having the two flaps, which is called as the bicuspid wall. In the right auriculoventricular aperture, the wall is having the three flaps, that is called as the tricuspid walls. So, wall which is present in the auriculoventricular aperture, that prevent the backflow. In left side, the two flapped, called as the bicuspid. In left, right side, three flapped, that is called as the tricuspid. So, internally, the heart is having the four chambers and there is the flow of the blood. So, dear students, for today, it is sufficient. So, you see this video, you listen this video and then you send your presenting. Simply, present sir and your name. Remember, send your name. First you write message, present sir, and then who is present. So give your name. Your name. So then I will see those who are studied, who are listened, who are watched the today's period, and I will put your attendance. So students, we are already completing the second unit. Then after completing this chapter, we will arrange the test on two units, first unit and two unit. So, we are going in proper way. We are not back. We are going the proper way. and don't cry about the corona. You make your way to study hard. So students, send your presentee. For today, we have studied the types of hurt, neurogenic hurt, myogenic hurt, then structure of human hurt, external structure of human hurt, and internal structure of human hurt. So for today, it is sufficient. Thank you very much.